So this is video 16. We will continue with the objectives of the National Iodine Deficiency Disorder Control Program. So to survey and find out the magnitude, to do a survey and to find out how much it has been affected, to distribute or supply of iodized salt in place of just giving, you know, non-iodized salt. They made it a trend of giving iodized salt, to resurvey after 5 years. So after giving iodized salt and people started using, resurvey should be done after 5 years to assess if still this iodine deficiency disorder was, you know, found, and the impact of the iodized salt, and then laboratory monitoring of iodized salt and urinary iodine excretion can be done, and then it was done, and then to provide health education and publicity through IEC, information education communication. Next, song and drama division. So these were all the programs, you know, that were used, I mean, through the IEC. They made sure that health education was given to people. So we see that the song and drama division has also been associated with the IEC activities under NIDDCP. These activities will be carried out in the form of folk. They will use some song, put their own words, and they'll try to, you know, do it through street play, dance, drama, local troops at the village level. They will perform. All this is done to take their attention. Okay, so their attention helps them. And then, because, you know, you attract the group and then you teach them. Only then they will be able to follow and they will show their participation. Then the emphasis of such activities was done in, you know, places like Bihar, Jharkhand, UP, Uttanchal, Madhya Pradesh, Chhattisgarh, Rajasthan, Odisha. Then All India Radio. So it was also told in the All India Radio. The 30 seconds radio spots in IDD was developed in 12 regional languages. It was proposed to broadcast these spots through the various primary channel, including so local, you know, radio stations. Wider publicity was given, and then categories of film, music, and just before the regional news, they did this program from the local Akashwani Kendras. Okay, so then next we see health education and publicity through state governments also included. Okay, so in addition to conducting IEC activities as mentioned above the apex level, the state government are also provided financial assistance to conduct IEC activities at the district level according to local needs. These activities include special program on Global IDD Day, advertisements in newspapers, organization of rallies by school children, radio talk. So these are the various methods how they provided health education to the public people. Ban on non-iodized salt. So the Ministry of Health and Family Welfare have imposed restriction on the sale of non-iodized salt for direct human consumption in the entire country. So they banned. So if at all salt, it should be only iodized salt, which will prevent, you know, iodine deficiency disorder. So with this, we have done with National Iodine Deficiency Disorder Control Program. Next, we will move on to expanded program on immunization, which I think you have already studied in childhood, already you have studied in your second year or first year for GNM, community health. So we will just, you know, revise. So all the tableau column that is given here, you have to by heart. Okay, I'll be posting the notes. Just go through and then study. So I think you will have to study by your own. The two pages are regarding, you know, the vaccine. Okay, so national immunization schedule, and then national immunization schedule according to the age wise that is given. You will have to by heart the last two pages. So we will see about the introduction. So immunization program is one of the key interventions for protection of children from life threatening conditions which are preventable. So this can be prevented, right? So that's the reason we give immunization. These are vaccines which are given, which are not produced. These antibodies are not there in the body. That's why through vaccination we are giving it. It is one of the largest immunization program in the world and major public health intervention in the country. Immunization program in India was introduced by WHO in 1978. So it was introduced in 1978. It was introduced as expanded program of immunization. The program gained momentum in 1985 and was expanded as universal immunization program to be implemented in phase. So in 1978 it was expanded EPI, okay, expanded program of immunization. Then it gained in momentum in 1985 and it was expanded as universal immunization program, which was followed by all over the world, to be implemented in phased manner to cover all the districts in the country 1989 to 90. So UIP became a part of child survival and safe motherhood program, CSSM. Okay, and then we see in 1992. Since 1997, immunization activities have been an important component of national reproductive and child health program, and it's currently one of the key roles. So we see how it has become an important function also in the National Rural Health Mission. So immunization, very important. So first it was EPI, then it became UPI, and then it has also become a necessary component of CSSN in 1992. Okay, and it also plays, you know, it is also a component in National RCH, okay, National Child Health Program, as well as in the National Rural Health Mission, okay, since 2005. Under the Universal Immunization Program, Government of India is providing vaccination to prevent 7 vaccine. So mainly, you know, killer disease, okay, we prevent diphtheria pertussis, tetanus, okay, DPT, then polio, measles, tuberculosis, okay, and hepatitis B. So mainly to prevent these diseases, we give immunization. So what are the objectives of EPI? So to reduce the morbidity and mortality of six major childhood disease, we call that as killer disease. Then to achieve 100% coverage, we have to cover all the children irrespective of rural or urban. Then deliver integrated immunization services through health center primary services, okay. So it has to be a integrated, okay, immunization services which could be given. So participation of the PHC community. So now you see, right, immunization is also encouraged by the nursing students. You go, you take, you know, work under PHC and you give. So it is an integrated part which has become as a service package. To develop a surveillance close observation system which collect adequate information on the disease prevention by immunization. So how far it is bringing an impact, that close, you know, observation to be done to minimize the efforts and cost of treatment to promote a new healthy generation. So these are all the various objectives. Next, talking about the strategies of EPI. So integrate vaccination sessions with PHC services. So they integrate, they work together, okay, they collaborate and work. Then appropriate measures to expand the vaccination coverage to eligible population, making sure that it is covering all the population, ensuring regular supply should be done of the medicine, strengthening the cold chain. It has to be maintained in particular degree Celsius, right? So making sure that is being done. Then training of health personnel, promotion of community participation, incorporating health education related to expand program of immunization, ensuring logistic support, supply and equipments, and then introducing a system for continuous monitoring and periodic evaluation, undertaking operational research to find out any deficiency or difficulty in the program. So conducting research and find out whether all the population is being covered, or any you know, problem with the resources, or any problem of not accomplishing the program. So all this can be done through research. So these are the various strategies under EPI. We'll see what are the targets. So usually target is under 5 years of age, women and childbearing, okay, age, that is 15 to 45 years. Then schedule of immunization, type of vaccine, dose of each vaccine, route of administration, precautions of vaccination. So these are to be kept in mind, okay, and these are the targets when it comes to the program. Next, we'll see milestone in the immunization program in India. So routine immunization is one of the most cost-effective public health intervention and was first introduced in India in 1978. It was introduced. So we see, you know, you can just go through this flow chart, 78, 85, 86, 90, 92, what are the various programs, okay, what was the various vaccination that was included. So in 1978, we see expanded program of immunization introduced after smallpox eradication. So BCG, DPT, OPV, typhoid, limited to mainly urban areas, they were giving all this vaccination. In the year 1985, universal UIP was got introduced. They expanded to entire country. Measles also got added. Close monitoring and less than 1 year of age was done. 86, technology mission. 90, they concentrated even on vitamin A supplementation. 92, CSSM program was started. 95, polio national immunization days were given, declared. So on that particular day, they will be vaccinating, that we know, right? And 97, RCH program they started. And 2005, again, second phase of RCH, a National Rural Health Mission was started. So these are the milestones in which the immunization was given. Okay, it was also emphasized along with the other programs. So cold chain, we know that it's a system of storing and transporting vaccine at a recommended temperature from one point of manufacture to the point of use. So once when you store, it is kept in the, you know, cold thermocol box so that it can be easily used, so that the vitality of the medicine is not lost, okay, or the efficiency of the medicine is not lost. The key elements of the cold chain are personal, equipment, procedures, okay, these three. So mainly you see, to manage vaccine storage and distribution, personnel should be trained also how to store it, how to distribute it. Equipment to store, the usually you see a thermocol, a hot pack, like a cold pack storage which they carry, okay, to store and transport vaccine, to a monitor temperature, then to ensure vaccines are stored and transported at appropriate temperature, okay. And then we also see here your tabular column, you can go through this. According to WHO, what is the national immunization schedule for infant, children and pregnant women? So for pregnant women, TT, one dose, second dose is been given early in the pregnancy, and TT 4 weeks after TT one dose is given. Then again you have booster dose, okay, if received two TT doses in a pregnancy with the last 3 years, okay. So yeah, so mainly two dose of TT is given. So then you see BCG, hepatitis, OPV, pentavalent, okay, and then pneumococcal, okay, all these medications when they are given, rotavirus, IPVs, please go through this and by heart it and where. So here you should know which vaccine at what age, dose, route and site it is given. And then you have vaccine age, dose, okay, for booster dose, it is a continuation of the page 16, okay, and then please read that, and national immunization. So according to the age, birth, 6 weeks, okay, so usually, so national immunization schedule, this is for children and for pregnant mother, and we follow this only, okay. So you can study this at birth, 6 weeks, 10 weeks, 14 weeks, and then you have, 9 to 12 months, 16 to 24 months, 5 to 6 years, 10 years, 16 years, and pregnant mother it is given, okay. So all this you have to study the schedule. So with that we are completing our expanded program of immunization, okay, and the schedule you have to study, okay. So I think in the next class we will carry on with other programs.